Well, I applaud Alcorn and the fight of their team, and they came in playing extremely hard and made some big plays and kept the lead. And we made a dash back for it. You know, they've been able to shut us down and wouldn't allow us to dash back into the game. So, you know, I can't say much except congratulations to the coach and his first year and a big win, and got his kids playing for him and doing a fine job for him. And, you know, I'm sure as this contest continues, there'll be more great fights, and, you know, and I'm looking forward to it.
Coach, I guess first off, talk about the offense. Another day where wasn't able to put points on the board.
Yeah, it was a tough day offensively. Another day was tough. You know, I thought maybe the change with Trey would put, you know, a quick six on the board early, and thought we'd come back and be able to mass some points on the board. But as the game wore on, you know, they were able to put pressure on us a little bit up front and stop some things and get some sacks. But, you know, we hurt ourselves, you know, holding penalties and different type of things that kept some drives alive for them. And, you know, it was just a situation where we just didn't play well. It's not, I don't think it was just Trey. I don't think it was just the things they were doing. I think it was a lot more of what we were doing to allow them to stay in the ball game, you know. And it was, you know, too many, four holding penalties and, you know, just mental mistakes out there, and you just can't have it when you're trying to win a football game. We drive in and we drive back out, drive into the red zone, drive back out. You know, can't even get in there and get a chip shot for a field goal and try to add points to it in order to maybe win it with kicking. You know, we keep stubbing ourselves in the toe, and they took advantage of that. And you know, when you got a team hanging around that long, they're going to eventually win a game, because you know it's like giving somebody a stick to beat you with.
Coach, 3-7, the first losing season here at Jackson State. Kind of wrap up what you're feeling now.
Well, I'm disappointed. You know, it's my first losing season I've had in a long, long time. You know, I'm used to winning, and we just got to take the good with the bad. I'm not going to commit suicide over it. You know, I just got to try to go back and get the team better. You know, and I think the guys that we got coming back are young, and you know, we're not losing that many guys, you know, that contribute to the football team overall. You know, three that really contribute on offense and defense. If you per se that, the guys who were starters, but I think we got a good team coming back, a young team. We didn't recruit a lot of junior college guys last year, so we'll have those guys for 3 or 4 years, and so I think we got something to build on. And we got some talent. We just had young talent that made young mistakes.
We talk about the offensive struggles, though. What does that mean, though, in the turn of the offense? Is there going to be changes made? I mean, there's all kinds of rumors swirling. What does that mean, coaching staff?
Well, you know, there's a lot of rumors going to swirl. You know, I'm going to sit back tonight and reflect on what took place all year long and make some decisions down the road. I'm not going to make any quick decisions after a loss or a game. You know, I want to sit back and watch a little bit with some more film and see how this game ended up, just like I do all games, and then we'll go ahead and plan our future from there.
It was particularly galling. You had the punt deal where they blow a snap. You got the ball on the 15-yard line. You lose 15 yards.
Yes.
Was that the microcosm of this game?
You know, it just seemed to be that way. You know, we see every time we turned around, it was a yellow flag on the floor, and mm-hmm. and it hurt us. It hurt us tonight, the yellow flags, you know, laying down there. And, you know, I thought the officials did the best they could, but it seemed like every time we got something going, we had a yellow flag. And you can't play football like that.
Was Keenan okay?
Keenan, he played with a gimp. He tried to go for it, but he played. He was about 80%. But he wanted to go. He wanted to try to give us a lift, but he, he did the best he could, you know, as far as trying to run routes and trying to get people to double team him, and so we could have an open receivers.
What was going on up front? They seemed to play in your backfield all day long.
I really couldn't tell you right now until I saw a film. I thought it was just basic protection, but you know, they were strong up front. You know, they were in the hunt. Sometimes they sent three men, you know, some four men. You know, it's not that they blitzed all day. You know, they just did a, you know, had a little more fight than our guys did up front. And I thought our guys, you know, had to fight, prepared to fight. And but they came in with, you know, and really pushed our front.
What happened on the two touchdowns?
They were quick slants, quick twos, and they came out. It looked like, you know, double, you know, some picks. I mean, I picked the corners, you know, slide inside and get a quick two, and they hit it and took for, those kids took them for, you know, long routes, you know, that, you know, you wouldn't see them if they were picks unless you really actually saw them, but, you know, they were, they caught us in man coverage and you know, went and picked the corners, and, you know, he, the other kid slanted side, and he was off and running.
Did you guys expect Buckley to run a little bit more? That's what...
Well, you know, you always schedule for Buckley to run. I mean, if he could run more, you know, we try to close the middle down on him. So he couldn't run as much, but, you know, he's the type of guy who ran all season long. And he would have ran, I think, if those opportunities came like they did every now and then they did tonight.
Did you expect them to run the ball as much as they did?
Did I expect it? I knew they were going to run the zone. They had a big back there. I expected them to run the football, you know, because in a passing game, they bring all the routes into Buckley, you know, the sixes, the twos, the eights, so that showed that, you know, on the outside, the long ball is a tough throw for him, so they bring everything in for him. So I thought, you know, bringing everything into him, that they would probably run the football. You know, when you see their route scale, everything is here so he can see it, you know, so that means that they're going to run the football.
What were they doing so well, or what weren't you guys doing?
They were executing well. They did a good job of executing and blocking well up front. You know, they did a fine job. You know, they did a fine job of blocking well. The running back did a fine job of, you know, finding that open hole in the zones. You know, they did a good job. You know, Buckley did a good job of, you know, leading, you know, that charge. And I think he changed some plays up. I think he did a good job from the sidelines calling and helping him out on the field. You know, so they did a real good job.
I saw Kerry change early. What happened with him?
Kerry change.
Kerry Hoskins?
Kerry was limping around a little bit. He was playing, you know, at least about 80%. He was hurt, you know, but he was still going to go and give us what he got because, you know, that's all we had left at the time. We could make some moves, but they would have been with some of the other guys.
What you got to say to the guys at?
Well, you know, everybody has their day. It wasn't our day. Everybody has their day, and we'll have our day. You know, we got to get in the weight room, and, you know, right now, you know, this is not baseball round robin where you get a second chance at them in the same year. You know, it's football. You got to sit back and wait a whole year to get them back. You know, and sometimes that's a long wait, but yet still, I think we'll be back and, you know, and be handling business again next season. But I think these guys now understand what it's all about to play in this game and what it's all about to play throughout a season and what it's going to take to win.
What didn't work in your run game?
I think they closed down the inside, our zones. I think they closed the inside down. And as I said, you know, I thought they were, you know, pushing us around a little bit up front, you know, showing a little bit, they were a little bit more physical than I think we anticipated.
Said you were going to take your time and, you know, obviously not make any rush decisions right after the game. Do you have a time in your head that you'd like to
make some of
those decisions are or evaluate the entire season?
No, I'm just going to take my time.